We can start. I would like to do with you a sample calculation. This is the calculation which is in your handout. You remember that the situation that we have a sewer in each road. And first I would like to do with you a sample for the wastewater collection. For the stormwater. Then for the wastewater collection, and finally we discuss shortly the combined system. Because one person is doing the combined system, so I also to include that that example. You see that in this area is given the number of the area. Here is given the area in hectare, and here are the is the legend for the wastewater production and for the rainfall intensity. I am coming to that back in a moment. Then you see here you have calculation point 1 and here calculation point 2. And here the ground level is given. I try to make it a bit clearer. No, I cannot make it clear. For the stormwater, we use here open channels. That's the standard type of open channels which we are going to use, which is given as an example in the handout. And we would like to know first what is the minimum gradient of these open channels. Because if you have the minimum gradient and you find then a certain flow, we can select immediately the open channel. Now you see here for this open channel with a depth of 3/4 of the width. We calculate the hydraulic radius and so on. We discussed it on Monday. And we have then for various sizes, we calculate the minimum slope, the full velocity, and the flow when running full. So when you find at a certain point a flow, for example, a flow of 400 liters per second, then we know that, well, this may do is a bit too small. We have then to use an open drain normal 80. Correct?
Open drain is 80, use 80?
For 400. Yeah, well, of course, you can say 385 is so near the 400, I take the smaller one. I won't say that is a bad solution because, you know, it is based on estimates. Runoff factor and so on are all based on estimates. Now, to look at the table, which is in the handout, you go from point 1 to point 2, then the tributary area is given, T1. Here the area in hectare is given, 1.5, which is given on your map, you take it from the map. Then the runoff factor is 0.65, and for the runoff factor, there are 4 classes. I put them here in the table. For class A, it is 10%. For class B, 35%. For class C, is 65%. And in the legend was given C, class C, for the runoff factor. Then for the other criteria is the rainfall. For the rainfall is given a formula. In Germany, they like to work with formulas. You know, when you have an ID curve, they make a formula of it. Sometimes I see a participant that he has an ID curve, and also he makes a formula. Of course, you can do that. Yeah? It's not required. And you can also, what I always do, I simply take it from the IDF curve. And but this formula is 2035 divided by t plus 9 liter per second per hectare. And that is for a concentration time larger than 10 minutes. Why larger than 10 minutes? Well, when it starts to rain, there is no water in the pipe. So before you get the maximum flow, the pipe must be filled. Yeah? And it takes about 10 minutes to fill the pipe. You can calculate the volume of all of the pipes which you have in the system. Yeah? And then you find the storage. We discussed it yesterday with pumping station to find the storage from the IDF curve, from the rainfall mass curve. And in the Netherlands, the storage is 15 minutes. This, after 15 minutes, the pipe is full. And then you have this, the maximum flow. So this means that for a time less than 15 minutes, you don't need to take a higher intensity. Huh? So the intensity curve has this shape like this. Here is 15 minutes. Here it is a straight line. Right? We don't need to consider the shorter intensities of 5 minutes or 10 minutes. In your case, I have said 10 minutes, because 15 minutes is for the Netherlands. But you know, when you have a sloping area, it is of course less. It might even be 5 minutes. For this exercise, I assumed 10 minutes. So when it's smaller than 10 minutes, then you take this, this intensity here. And then for larger than 15 minutes, you take the IDF curve. So now we can continue that we have 1.5 hectare times the runoff factor gives a reduced area, that is area times runoff factor, that is given in here, is 0.98. Then I also give the cumulative amounts. It's a total amount, because it adds up for the second, the third, and the fourth section. But for the first section, it is 0.98. I assume that the time of concentration is 10 minutes. That's an assumption, yeah? Then for 10 minutes, I found 107 liter from the formula. Smaller than 10 minutes, it was 107 liter per second per hectare. Then the intensity times the area is equal to 103. That's the total flow in the channel. Do you agree with this? Is that okay? Yeah? What I did is, I have here the area times the Renolf vector gives the reduced area. The area times the Renolf vector is A times Psi. Multiply times the rainfall intensity gives me the total flow. Now for this flow, I have then to find, you know, a profile. Well, here you see the ground level is 10.8 at the upper end and 9.8 at the lower end. And the length is 100 meters. The sections are 100 meters. So what you have to do is always, when you design a drain, make a sketch. It is difficult, you know, to do it without a sketch. Well, here I have 10 meters, here I have 9.8. That's the ground level. The slope of the ground level is 10 minus 9.8 over 100 meters. That is that is 2 per thousand. That's the slope of the ground. Now I have an amount of 103 liters. So what channel do I need? Well, if I look at the smallest channel, it's a pity that this is not so clear. Oh, now it's better, I think. This should be better. Well, you see, the smallest one, that is with a width of 50 centimeters, that is this size, and this water depth, you don't really make them smaller, you know? You don't make channels like this one. Pipes, yes, but with channels, you don't do that. In practice. That is also for maintenance. And the smallest one has a flow of 186 liters per second. So you use the smallest one. And you see that the minimum slope is 2.18, is a bit more than the ground slope. Because that was the question. Do we follow the ground slope? When you have sufficient slope available, or must we, is the area so flat that we have to apply the minimum slope? So here you see that we have to apply the minimum slope. The difference, of course, is very small, of 2.18. Now, we can design the drain. The drain will have a freeboard, 15 centimeter for a drain, let's say 60 centimeters wide and smaller. And the depth is 37.5. here we have the drain. We calculate the invert. Well, the freeboard here is 15 centimeters. The depth here is 37.5. So the invert is then 947. Okay, that's the invert. Then the invert at the lower end, that is then equal to 947 minus S times L, that is 2.18 times 100. So we have that to deduct 22 centimeters. And then we get 9.25 meters elevation.
How much is
this?
Depth of the freeboard. That writing is small, you can't read.
You can't see?
Yeah, it's small.
This is 10 meters,
yes.
The ground level.
Yeah.
The freeboard is 15 centimeters. The water depth is 37.5. That is the water depth. So then I calculate the invert at 9.47. That's also given in the table here. Okay? That is the upper level. The lower level is a slope times a length. That is 22 centimeters, and then I get 947 minus 22 is 9.25. That is here in your table here. That's the design, okay?
I have a previous question related to the concentration time. You were saying that you take 10 minutes?
Yeah, less than 10 minutes,
less
yes.
Less than 10 minutes, that is the estimation you do in the Netherlands.
What? Well, this is just an assumption.
Okay.
If it is not correct, I will find later.
Okay.
Okay.
So in our case, for the whole catchment, we take this concentration?
No, for the first section.
For the first section?
Yes, because once we have the concentration time, here at this point, we continue with that concentration time.
Okay, so for every calculation point, we will have a new concentration time. Is that right?
Well, here, I'm coming to that later.
Okay.
I'm coming to that because that's the end of the table, the calculation of the concentration time. You make an assumption for the concentration time, you do all the calculations, and then at the end you find the concentration time. And then we have to see if we have to do the calculation again or not. Yeah?
Do we add up all the concentration time for each section at the end of the pipe?
No, you continue with the concentration time. Yeah? But we come to that, yeah? Now we put in here the details, the slope, the profile, the capacity of the drain, and the velocity of the drain. Now we have to determine the velocity occurring, because this is the velocity for flowing full, but the drain is only 55% full, because 103, that is the flow, divided by the capacity, 186 is 55%. Then from the partial flow diagram, we determine the the velocity. This partial flow diagram is also in the handout. And this is the relative depths, and here the relative velocity and flow, what we need. For a flow of 55%, you see, we find then this depth here, about 60% of 37 centimeter, and we find here this velocity, and the velocity is then 87% of the full velocity, and we calculate that, and then we find here a velocity of 0.86. Okay? That's the velocity occurring in the channel for the flow, because the flow is not full. The channel is not full. Yeah? Then now we can calculate the time. The time is t is L over V. That is dus 100 over the velocity is 0.86. And we find then that the flow time, this from to flow from here to here, is 116 seconds. We have an inlet time. At the upper end there is an inlet time. If the roof is connected by a house connection to the channel, within a number of seconds the water will be there. If you have your scoped roof, if you have a flat roof, or the water has to go over the ground to the channel, it takes longer. Here it is assumed that the inlet time is 10 minutes. It could also be 5 minutes. It could also be longer, it depends on the area, it depends on the local conditions. The 10 minutes is an assumption. Of course, you can find that in the practice, in the area where you live. Some people measure that. But here we assume 10 minutes. 5 minutes. 5 minutes is 300 seconds. Plus 116, so the total time is 416 seconds, that is 7 minutes. So the assumption is correct, isn't it? Because I assumed less than 10 minutes. Now I will do the second section. That's from 2 to 3. And then I will say, okay, let's assume a time of also smaller than 10 minutes. Let's say it also takes 2 minutes. 116 seconds is 2 minutes. So we have then 9 minutes. It's smaller than 10 minutes, right? Yeah? Do you think that is Do you agree with me to take the same time? It's the same length?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Then, from 2 to 3, we do the same. We have an area of 1 hectare. On the legend, it is said that the runoff factor is C, class C, that is 65%. And so the contribution is then the area times the runoff factor is 0.65 hectare. So total, the cumulative amount is then 0.98 plus 0.65 is then 1.63 hectare. So for this sewer, I have then 0.63 hectare. The flow. Times the flow is then equal to the area times the rainfall intensity is 174 liter per second. Well, what I have to do now is make a sketch first. And I see now that the ground level is going down to 9 meters. So the slope, I don't think we need to calculate it. But you see that the slope is more than 2 per thousand. So now we have to follow the slope of the sewer. Because the slope is more than the minimum slope. When we look at the table, if we would follow the minimum slope, then we still have then 2.18 as a minimum slope for that flow. But we have a much bigger slope. You can see that from the curve. And so what we do then, here the soap, here the sewer, the channel went down a little bit, and here we can apply the freeboard again. So the invert we can calculate. So here we have a freeboard of 15 centimeters, 0.15. And if I take the same channel, I assume that now, 37.5, then I get here 8.47. This one I should put in here. That was 9.25. So the slope of the drain is from 9.25 to 8.47. Here the drain is a little bit deeper to follow the minimum slope. Here I have the no excess depths anymore. So I have here the freeboard plus the depth, so I get here a depth of 8.47. And the slope is then equal to 9.25 divided by minus 8.47 over 100. And when we look at the table, we calculate the slope at 7.8. At this slope we calculate then the flow. We find 352. We can do that with any formula you want to use. And the velocity is 1.87 meter per second. And the filling depth for the flow is 49%. And the partial velocity is 1.59 meter per second. The full velocity is 1.87, and the partial velocity from the partial flow diagram, the same diagram which I use, I find then 1.59. Okay, well then we can complete it. We can calculate the flow time, 63 seconds. We find then a total flow time. It's correct, 63 seconds. A total flow time of 8 minutes. So now we have the design and we have the concentration time to continue from point 3. And you see that the next one is flat again, 9 meters. And then the following one is also, is even the ground level is all even going up. Here a little bit going down, so this area is completely flat, you can see. So we have everywhere, we're following then the minimum gradient, and the drain will go deeper and deeper. The drain also will get larger and larger, and you see that the drain we get here profile 50, here a profile 60 centimeters wide, here 70 centimeters wide, here 80 and here 90. So you get then a situation, I just draw it here, you have here a channel and then we get a larger channel. So if we keep the bottom the same, we get this one. And then we get a larger tunnel. And so on. So you see, I keep the bottom the same, but the depth, the water depth increases. Well, they apply that perhaps in the Netherlands. Keep the bottom the same. But I never do that. And generally in the world also they don't do that. Because then you get a backflow. This gives a backflow here. Then you don't have the attractive force anymore. Okay, the attractive force could be calculated for a smaller flow. But the gradients in open drains is rather flat. So what I do is, I only consider the water, maximum water level, when flowing full, when the drain is flowing full. And what I do is, I keep that level the same. So then I get a situation, a profile, like this here. Here's the drain, first drain. Here's the second drain. You see, I get steps here. And the steps are then 7 centimeters, because the width is increasing with 10 centimeters, then the depth is increasing with 7.5 centimeters. So I make steps of 7 centimeters. Okay? There's a reason why I keep the water level the same, is because the gradients are rather flat. I could otherwise reduce it here. Then I save a little bit of excavation. And then the water level will then be okay for the tractor force. But for the maximum flow, there will be a small backflow. That's also acceptable, of course. Some people do that calculation. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I'll put your question. Can you move your slides? I want to see the first part. Your slide.
Sorry?
Can you move your slide? I want to see the first part. I want to show you the first part.
This part or the end?
The first one. When you say your runoff coefficient is 0.65.
Okay, you come here to explain it. It's easier.
All right. You say your runoff coefficient is 0.65. And it's on the... I don't know where you get the 0.65.
Yes. 6.5?
Yes.
That is given, which is on the map.
For the assignment?
Yes.
But
that is, you have in your design paper, you have 3 classes. Here we have 4 classes, A, B, C, and D. You see, I have here class C. Here is class C. Here is perhaps class B, you see?
Okay.
There are different classes. That is given, that's a criteria.
Oh, but when you are doing in practice, where do you get those classes from? How do you determine this is class D, this is class C, this is class B? How do you do that?
You mean to determine the runoff factor?
Yes.
No.
To determine the runoff factor, you see, when I do it, I do it by experience a little bit. In Korea, it was a city of 2 million people. With an aeroplane, they take aerial pictures. And then we looked at all those pictures. And we made an estimation. Then we go on site. And then we determined a factor. Then, after 2 years, we had the measurements, we had rainfall recorders, we had flow recorders, and we compared. You see? So we did that. But many people, they don't measure it, they just estimate it. Okay?
Okay. Put back on your your table, I've got another question.
Sorry?
Put again your table, I've got another question.
No, you slide it yourself.
Did?
put your table again, I've got another question.
For the table?
Yes. So, after you get this 0.65, where do you use this here? Where do you use the 0.65?
Well, this you understand, huh?
Yeah, this is cumulative area.
Yes.
From this.
This is a cumulative area. This is the area.
It, this and this.
This is a cumulative area. This plus this is this.
Yes.
For the next session, this plus this is this.
I understand. What about this one? Where did you put this one?
This is the runoff factor.
Yes.
This is taken from the map.
And where do you use it on the table?
Huh?
Where do you use it along the table?
Yes, of course.
Which
this
part?
I take from the map.
Yes, then you put it here. So you don't use it anywhere in the table.
No, you use it in the next column. The next column is the...
This one?
Yeah.
That's not
that one.
This is area.
No.
Yes. You see, this is the area which is measured.
Yes.
This is the runoff factor.
Yes.
Runoff factor times the area reduces the area. That gives the reduced area, which is given here.
Ah, okay.
Yeah?
So this is distance, this, you get this?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Yes. It is also said at the top of the table, the factors, how you arrive at that. At top of the table is the formula given for each column. One more remark. So this is the design for the stormwater drains. I would like now to do it for the wastewater channels, for the wastewater pipes. Which are easier. For the wastewater pipes, I also need the minimum gradients. And in this case, I have said, I want a sewer system which is self-cleansing. So then I need a tractor force of 1.2 at 10% filling rate. And I need that for various diameters. I think in your case, if you do it for these diameters, that would be sufficient. And so then this is my criteria for the minimum gradients. You see, for around 25, I have a flow of 38 liters. And for around 50, I have a flow of 96 liters. And the slope is here given. So that's the design criteria for the flat areas. Further, I have three classes, class 1, 2, and 3, and respectively they are 0.8, 1.2, or 1.6 liter per second per hectare. There's a groundwater infiltration of 1.5 liter per second per kilometer sewer. Of course, kilometer sewer, which are below groundwater table. So then you can take the whole area, which is below groundwater table. It's the same layout which I'm using. This is for 40 centimeter pipes, that was for stormwater. The result of the calculations given here. We do it now for wastewater. You see here the area is the same. And here you see we have class 2. I also have to tell you that we have here a heavy producer, a laundry or whatever, that produces wastewater here, which is 5 liters per second. So we have, this is, the people are done on an area basis, and the heavy producers are a single producer. Well, it's the same, the area T1. Yes?
Sorry, in relation to the sewage quantity, you are saying for big producers, here in the data we are given water consumption. So we may use a coefficient to change it into sewage.
Yeah.
Which coefficient do we use?
Yeah, you have got in your data one heavy producer.
Yes.
Yes. And that we have said.
But we have the water the heavy producer use and the water that people use, but we don't have any coefficient to use, I know, 90%, 80%.
For the heavy producers, no, that is the wastewater given.
Okay. And for the
yes, people? That's the wastewater is given.
And for homes?
For the wastewater, of course, that is related to the water consumption.
So we estimate a factor we
yes, that's a design criteria. You assume
okay.
How much water of the water consumption is not entering your sewer.
Okay.
You use water for water for your car, perhaps for the garden or for whatever. Yeah? Okay, then well, this was class 2, that is then that has a rate of wastewater production of 1.2 liter per second per hectare. That's the design criteria. That times the area gives 1.8. Then we have here a single producer. It is 1.5 hectare. The 1.5 is cumulative hectare. That is for the whole section. That is 5 liters per second per hectare. So total we have 6.8. This plus this gives 6.8 liter per second. That is the total flow. Infiltration, 0, because above the groundwater table. And now we can design the sewer. Again, we have to make a sketch. Oh, I have to. Well, for the sewer, we have here a ground level of 10 meters and here a ground level of 9.8. The sewer pipes, they have a cover of 1 meter. 1 meter cover you need for the house connection. It could be less, of course, but then you have to calculate it. But we assume that if we have 1 meter, we can connect the houses. But in practice, it may be that you reduce it, but then you have to calculate it exactly for a house connection with a slope of 150 and so on. Then we say, okay, we have here a cover of 1 meter. The minimum diameter for a wastewater sewer is 25 centimeters. A few centimeters would be sufficient for the first pipe, but we don't have clean water, like water distribution. We have water where all kinds of materials are thrown into the sewer, rags, ropes, anything what people, you know, can put into the toilet can go into the sewer. And that is why we need a minimum. A minimum diameter of 25. So the invert here is then 8.75. Well, this is rather a flat slope. And now we look at the table. What slope we should use. And then we see that for the minimum diameter, we have a slope of 4 per thousand, a flow of 38 liters per second, running half full is 19, let's say half of it reserved for the illicit stormwater. Our flow is 6.8. Then we can, we have this slope of 4 per thousand, so that we can calculate this here. 40 centimeters lower we are. And we have here an invert of 8.35. And so we continue, okay? So we plug in all the values. We have the slope, profile, capacity. This now it is finished, the design. Now there are two more columns. And that is for the peak flow. How much is the peak flow? And we see, and how much is the velocity? You could also ask the tractor force. Well, here we have 18% filling, thanks to the industrial waste, to the heavy producer. It is more than 10%, so we have sufficient tractor force. That's the idea of these two columns. For the operation people to see how the system is functioning. If there's very little water, then we know that, you know, there will be some sedimentation. There's not a problem, but we are aware that if there's a problem, we could have a problem in those sewers. So it is for the operation people, is it interesting to have these two columns? Yeah, when we look at further at this, at the result of this table, you see that the diameter is increasing. First it is 25 centimeters, then to 30, then to 40. Well, that is all. And when the diameter increases, we see that the invert level, here they are the same because the diameter is the same, but here the invert level is going down from 7.35 to 7.32 with 3 centimeters. That's half the difference in the pipe diameter. You have a pipe, the pipe diameter changes from 25 to 30. So I go down with half the pipe diameter. So, oh. In the Netherlands, we would do like this.
I just wanted to sort of just say a little bit about the time.
Yes.
I think we're kind of...
I'm nearly finished.
Okay, all right then. Okay, just thought I'd mention.
Yes.
Reminder.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. You see, in the Netherlands we increase the diameter. And we keep the bottom the same. The problem is then that we get a backflow, and there's no sufficient tractive force. So if you want self-cleansing, you could also do it, as we discussed it, with the water channels, for the stormwater channels. But for wastewater, because the slopes are rather steep, it is better to keep the center lines of the pipes as a straight line. So we have here the top pipe. And so on. If you have here 30 centimeters and you have here 2 meters, that's a difference of 1.70 meters. So here you go. Here you go down nothing. Here you go down half of 1.70 meters. That's 85 centimeters. That's a big saving in excavation for wastewater. You see, when you have a problem with groundwater, what I normally do is I don't go deeper than 2 meters below the groundwater table. Then I make a pumping station. In the city of Rotterdam, they say, okay, we lay our sewers 1 in 500. Then for 2 kilometers, we can then connect to the pumping station. We can then drain an area of 2 kilometers, 2 by 2 kilometers. So that is to avoid problems with deep sewers, and also the investment costs are rising with deep sewers and groundwater. You need more expensive shuttering. So this is the way we do it, and you find it also in the handout for the wastewater, that we do it this way. Keep half the difference in diameter as a step. Well, then about the combined system. In the combined system, you have of course the stormwater and the wastewater. And now with Brinkum, there wouldn't be a problem, because the end of your main is the river. But with lakeside, there could be a problem, because you have different outlets, right? So if you have a combined system, and one of you even has the worst system, it has the outlet, the most far outlet away from the pumping station, so it has to bring the wastewater and passes all these stormwater drains, to receive the wastewater from there. Well, then you have this overflows at all those sections, and you get them. You start here. Here, there comes stormwater. Here comes stormwater. Here comes stormwater. Well, then from this point, from this stormwater which comes arrives there, you allow then 3 times the peak dry weather flow into the system. So from this area, 3 times the peak dry weather flow from stormwater, and 1 time the peak dry weather flow for wastewater. So total 4 times you allow into your sewer system. And that you introduce as a single producer, like we have done in the table like here. You put it simply in this column, in column number 3. You add there overflow number 1, so much. Overflow number 2, so much, with the following section, you see? In that way you calculate just the connecting, the transport system to the pumping station. So that is then, you say, a wastewater sewer with a certain amount of stormwater related to the wastewater. All right. I'm sorry it takes so much time. But, we reduced it to 1 hour, because in the morning there was a session, and in the afternoon, for which we thought we need 3 hours. And tomorrow, the next session is next week on Monday. So there was only 1 hour left today to give this lecture. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.